Inspires lifelong learning in its children through comprehensive, innovative curriculum and instruction. The district fully supports and expects the attainment of the New Jersey Core Curriculum Content Standards on the part of all students within a school environment designed to maximize student potential, develop responsible citizens, and promote respect for the uniqueness of all individuals. We are now going to open to the public on reorganization items. Items 7 through 14 only. Okay, seeing none, we're going to continue. I'm now going to announce the election results. Official board candidate results for three full year terms. Candidate Rita Walker received 1,174 votes. Mr. Jeremy Griffin received 1,050 votes, and Mrs. Nancy Shapiro received 944 votes. I would now like to administer the oath to our new board members.
Thank you. raise your right hand, please, and repeat after me. I do solemnly swear that I will support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of New Jersey, and that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same and to the governments established in the United States, and this state under the authority of the people. I do solemnly swear that I possess the qualifications prescribed by law for the office of member of the Board of Education, and that I am not disqualified as a voter pursuant to RS 19:4-1.
And that I am not disqualified as a voter pursuant to RS 19:4-1.
Nor disqualified due to conviction of a crime or offense listed in NJS 18A-12-1.
Nor disqualified due to conviction of a crime or offense listed in NJS 18A-12-1.
And that I will faithfully, impartially, and justly perform.
And that I will faithfully, impartially, and justly perform.
All the duties of that office.
All the duties of that office.
According to the best of my ability, so help me God.
According to the best of my ability, so help me God.
Congratulations. Now we're going to take a roll call. Mr. Griffin?
Yes.
Mr. Autumn?
Yes.
Mrs. Robertson?
Yes.
Mrs. Shapiro?
Yes.
Mrs. Walker?
Here.
Mr. Walsh?
Yes.
Mrs. Nichols?
Here.
Dr. Wesley? I'm now going to read the Oradell Board of Education trustees and the expiration of their terms of office. Jeremy Griffin, expiration 2020. Mrs. Shapiro, expiration 2020. Mrs. Walker, expiration 2020. Mr. Walsh, 2019. Mrs. Nichols, 2019. Mr. Westlake, 2019. Mrs. Norian, 2018. Mr. Otto, 2018. And Mrs. Robertson, 2018. I would like to ask now for a nomination for board president. Mrs. Shapiro, you're making the motion to appoint Mrs. Nichols as president and Dr. Westlake here as seconder. Thank you very much. Are there any other nominations for president?
I'd like to nominate Rita Walker.
Do we have a second for Mrs. Walker?
I decline. No, thank you for that confidence, but I decline. Thank you.
Do we have any others? Now roll call. Mr. Griffin?
I'll abstain.
Mrs. Shapiro?
Yes.
Mrs. Walker?
Yes.
Mr. Walsh?
Yes.
Mrs. Nichols?
Abstain.
Dr. Westlake?
Yes.
Mr. Otto?
Yes.
Mrs. Robertson?
Yes.
Mrs. Dorothy Watson Nichols, excuse me, is now the president of the Board of Education.
I'd like to open the floor to nominations for Vice President.
I nominate Christine Robinson.
I
Are there any other nominations? Mrs. Walter, would you like to make that motion?
Yes. I'd like to make a motion to nominate Christine Robinson as Vice President of the Oradell Board of Education, 2018.
Dr. Westlake, second. Roll call.
Mr. Griffin?
Yes.
Mr. Otto?
Yes.
Mrs. Shapiro?
Yes.
Mrs. Walker?
Yes.
Mr. Walsh?
Yes.
Dr. Westlake?
Yes.
Mrs. Robertson?
Holstein.
Mrs. Nichols?
Yes. Moving on to the Code of Ethics, we're going to vote on this one separately. We're going to read it. So I would ask Mr. Griffin to read the first paragraph, and we'll go around the table with the board members, and each of us will read a paragraph.
I will uphold and enforce all laws, state board rules and regulations, and court orders pertaining to schools. Desired changes should be brought about only through legal and ethical procedures.
I will make decisions in terms of educational welfare of children and will seek to develop and maintain public schools which meet the individual needs of all children regardless of their ability, race, creed, sex, and social status.
I will confine my board action to policy making, planning, and appraisal, and I will help to frame policies and plans only after the board has consulted those who will be affected by them.
I will carry out my responsibility not to abuse the school, but together with my fellow board members to see that they will run.
I will recognize that authority rests with the Board of Education and will make no personal promises nor take any private action which may compromise the board.
I will refuse to surrender any independent judgment to special interests or partisan political groups, or to use the school for personal gain or for the gain of friends. I will hold confidential all matters pertaining to the school which, if disclosed, would needlessly injure individuals or the school. But in all matters, I will provide accurate information and, in concert with my fellow board members, interpret to the staff the aspirations of the community board school.
I will vote to appoint the best qualified personnel available after consideration of the recommendation of the Chief School Administrative Officer.
I will support and protect school personnel in proper performance of their duties.
I will refer all complaints to the Chief School Administrative Officer and will act on such complaints at public meetings only after failure of an administrative solution.
Any questions? Roll call.
Mr. Griffin?
Yes.
Mr. Otto?
Yes.
Mrs. Shapiro?
Yes.
Mrs. Walker?
Yes.
Mr. Walsh?
Yes.
Dr. Westlake?
Yes.
Mrs. Robinson?
Yes.
Yes, but I realize we didn't make a motion for it, so I need a motion.
I'll make the motion.
All right, Mr. Walsh made the motion.
I second.
And Mr. Griffin seconded. Okay, I'm hoping someone would make a motion for consent agenda 7 to 14 for the rest of the reorg.
I move to approve 7 to 14 of the consent agenda.
I'll second.
Second.
Mr. Walsh, beat you, Mrs. Walker. Any questions? Call the question.
Mr. Otto?
Yes.
Mrs. Shapiro?
Yes.
Mrs. Walker?
Yes.
Dr. Westlake?
Mrs. Robinson?
Yes.
Mrs. Nichols?
Yes.
Mr. Walsh?
Yes.
Mr. Griffin?
Yes.
Okay, moving on, we're going to switch the order of vote for the next session.
Roll call.
We'll open to the public for agenda items only. Okay, at this time, we'll move forward. Board President's remarks, I'm actually going to ask Mrs. Robertson to say a few words at this time.
Kind of sad, very sad actually, to report the passing of a former PTA president, Serafina Begalt. Some of you may have heard. She was a president of the PTA for 2 years and a very active member of the PTA. I remember working with her on a couple of things, and I reached out to some of her colleagues at that time that were served with her for some of their insight, and some of the things they told me was that Serafina gave the responsibility of the PTA 100% of her efforts. She worked tirelessly on the mini grant programs to bring more programs to the school that we could offer to our children that we couldn't normally have done. And she always made sure that those programs were a part of the curriculum. Serafina was an avid reader. She brought many authors to OPS. She wanted the children to love reading as much as she did. And she was very passionate about it. She was involved in bringing the Star Lab and many other programs. She was a stickler for the rules and regulations. She knew them all. And she thought through decisions to try and understand what the impact would be for anyone involved. As a person, and on a more personal level, my relationship with Serafina, although we were not great friends, I mean, we knew each other, we worked together on some things, but I always found her to be very opinionated. She wasn't afraid to speak her opinion, but she was always respectful and thoughtful in what she said. She supported volunteers in this community. She always understood that there were two sides to every story, and even though we may not have always agreed, we always walked away respecting one another, and that was really important. She is a huge loss to our community, and I hope that tonight we can all say a prayer for her family, that they will find some peace and comfort in the very difficult days ahead. Thank you.
Thank you, Christine. At this time, I'm going to open the floor to any public comment. This is our public hearing on the addendum to the contract of employment for the superintendent of schools, so we are required to have a public hearing, so this is your chance to comment if you wish. Come down to the podium. You can state your name and address and you can sign the book. Is that mic on? We can take a 5-minute recess.
Thank you.
You want to continue now or after?
After.
Yeah, that's fine. Sure.
Thank you.
Okay, I'm going to reopen to the public. Some of my other comments, I want to make sure that you're well aware,